I may have hit my first snag, guys. The poor holes that are in the Myford bed that originally held the headstock on from the metal lathe have transferred onto the base of the headstock from the wood lathe, and I would trying to reuse those existing holes. So I've marked them out, but looking at it, the thickness of this wall goes right all the way down to this point, and if I carry on that on the way down, it looks let's transfer that across. Looking at that, I might just get away with it. That line there is the thickness of the sidewall at the bottom, and this is the these four crosses are the holes that are in the bed that I'd like to screw into. So I may just get away with it. Let me just measure what these diameter of these holes are. I may have dropped lucky, guys. Let me transfer this side across. This side's slightly different. I've had the wood headstock on the lathe and centralised it. I put the spindle back in and I've centralised it on the bed and checked it with the life sensor on the tailstock, so I know those lines correspond to the existing holes on the Myford bed, and then the headstock is centralised on the bed and also with the tailstock. But looking at that, what it means is this headstock, the width of this isn't centralised with the holes, because this side I'll get away with, I think, but on this side, I don't think there's enough space there to drill that hole and clear this side wall. On this side I may have to bring them in slightly and drill some new holes. I'll do these two first, see how those line up, check it again, and then make a decision on what I'm going to do with these two. Yeah, the four existing holes I wanted to reuse, they're drilled into the strongest part of the bed. There's an overhang on both sides by, I should say, half an inch. But the holes are drilled into this part of the bed, which is that pulls all the way through the full length, and they're not into the overhang. So if I bring them the holes in slightly on the headstock, I'm probably missing that strongest part. That's about half an inch thick there. Should be sufficient, but I still want to try and reuse these if possible. Well guys, I think I've come up with a solution for the headstock. I've got this piece of bar. This was attached to the lathe bed, and I'm presuming it was forming the taper turning attachment on the lathe. I'm not certain about that, but I can't see another reason for it being fastened onto the bike. And I've placed it on the bed and underneath the headstock and put the two centres in, and we're probably 1.5 millimetres high on this side. So I can machine that down. I'll probably get 4 lengths out of this for the width of the bed or width of the headstock. So the two holes that I can get away with were they don't interfere with the wall, side wall. I can go straight through this bar, through the bottom of the headstock into those two holes. The other side, where I haven't got enough space because of that wall, I can drill through the bar and use the two holes to secure the bar, and then I can put two more holes away from the sidewall into this bar and tap into that. So I think that's possibly the best solution I can come up with.
Okay, Venus?
Okay, Steve.
Right. Let's go.
Would be a fireball, a fireball. Every time I gazed into your starry eyes, We'd take the path to Jupiter, and maybe very soon we'd cruise along the Milky Way and land upon the moon. To a wonderland of stardust, we'll zoom our way to Mars. My heart would be a fireball, a fireball, 'cause you would be my Venus of the stars.
Well, guys, the other day I had a trip out to a good friend of mine, Buzz. He owns a scrapyard in Bury, he's very kind to give me some alloy wheels, a good source of aluminium for melting in the propane furnace, and I've got quite a few. This is just one that he gave me, and don't know what size this is. I can't find my tape, but must be 21, 22 inch diameter, and I'm presuming this is going to be decent aluminium, but I've got to sort of some way of cutting it down. Unfortunately, it won't fit into my crucibles as it is, so I was thinking of using the reciprocating saw. But I think what I might do, first of all, I'll mount it onto the vertical mill, clamp it down to the table, and take some slices off it first. It might make it easier. But I wouldn't like to buy one of those brand new. It's looking at the paint, I don't know if that's... I don't think it's had a hell of a bashing. But looking at the damaged rims, you've got the aluminium base, and then it looks like there's some maybe 1 millimeter filler on it. I don't know. Is it just paint? You can see the grey. It looks like it to me. It looks like a very fine coat of filler on, but. I've no idea how these are made. I don't think it's been patched up in the past, because even around the edges you can see the thickness. Maybe it's just a very thick primer that's put on, and then no, I've no idea how those are made. But as I say, I wouldn't like to buy one of those new. Just one last thing before I go, guys. I had been making some homemade chisels, and there's a SDS drill, well, it's a chisel bit with a large SDS end on it, and I'm presuming this will be good, decent steel, and I've been making one or two different style of turning chisels out of them, and this is one I started to machine down as a spindle roughing gouge. And I've got to a certain stage and it's just been left. I've never used that one. I had picked one or two up. I have used this, and this one works well. But the other day I bought another four on eBay. I was the only bidder on them, and they look really vintage ones. The handles are a bit grotty, but the actual steel and the chisel themselves look in decent condition. Now, those haven't arrived yet. Maybe this afternoon or tomorrow those should arrive. But the other night I was watching, I've been doing some watching wood, experienced wood turners on YouTube. A chap called Robo Hippie, I think he's called. Some of the videos go back quite a few years, but very entertaining videos that he does. He's experienced. I think he's a ball turner than anything else. But what I like about his videos, there's no bullshit in them. You know, you watch some of them, and a lot of it's just bullshit. You know who you are, guys. But it was chisel he was showing. It was a fluteless. spindle gouge. Now basically all it was a round bar with a flap machined on the top, so it was only half round, a bit of radius on the nose, and then I think he had a 60 degree angle ground onto the tip of it, and he was very impressed with those. So what I thought I'd do, forget about the gouge that I'd, the flute that I'd started machining, I'm going to cut that off, put this on the surface grinder, machine half a bit away so it's only half round, and then put a small radius on the tip and a 60 degree clearance angle, and see how I go on with that. But to be honest, I don't. If it's a fluteless gouge, what's the difference between that and a shaper? That's something I don't understand, guys. If you know that, maybe you can leave me some advice in the comments. Well, I'm going to wind it up there, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.